Can you talk about what makes events like this, festivals like this, both special and important?
I think, first and foremost, it's a very difficult thing to make a film, right? So that's always worth celebrating, especially an event like this, which is about celebrating a festival which gives a platform for filmmakers making independent film. I mean, that's something I really wanted to be a part of.
What do you think both a storyteller and an audience gets from indie cinema they perhaps don't get from more commercial-led, franchise, blockbuster, tentpole cinema?
Yeah, we have so much. We have such a variety of storytelling, I think, nowadays, and we're given so many opportunities to consume things, whether that's at home, whether that's box sets, whether that's whatever it is, radio, television, film, big franchise movies or independent films. You know, everyone has their own tastes, but I think it's exciting to see things that are a bit different. It's exciting to see things, see kind of filmmakers' first films, to see films that have been made maybe on a smaller budget where there's a lot of creative freedom. That's something I personally am into, and those limitations can bring a lot out of the process, I think, sometimes, if they can be well overcome. So I did a Christmas rom-com, which was an absolute joy to shoot with some wonderful people. Khayisa is in it, who's absolutely fantastic. Timothy Spall, Joanna Scanlon, Ben Miller, lots of lovely people. It's called This Christmas, and it's out this Christmas. And that's on Sky Cinema. And what else have we got? I did another film called The Critic, which was brilliant as well. Fantastic script, a sort of period, I'd say almost thriller. It sort of feels a bit noirish in some kind of elements, but it's another fantastic cast, Mark Strong and Ian McKellen and Gemma Arterton, and yeah, that was lovely to be part of. And Patrick Marber wrote the script for it, and it's fantastic. So that's called The Critic. That'll be out next year. And I'm rehearsing a play at the moment. I'm doing a production of As You Like It, which will open, I think our first preview is the 3rd of December, and we run basically December into January, to the end of January.
Working with a whole smorgasbord of talented people there. You mentioned Khayisa though, she's one of our favourite actresses. Can you talk about what it was like? What makes her so special, you think?
Oh, she's an absolute... She has such... Okay, she's a fantastic actor, but I think she has so much intelligence. She has intuition. She works with a beautiful openness. We had such a good time on this job, and everyone was lovely. But I mean, something else which struck me about Khayisa is she absolutely understands the camera, and she understands working on camera in a way I found sort of fantastically impressive. I mean, she really is brilliant.
Over the Christmas holidays, a lot of families across the country will be getting out that Harry Potter box set and working their way through that magical journey again, as they do every year. Can you talk about what it means for you to have been part of something that is still so beloved, so cherished, and so much a part of all our lives?
Yeah, I mean, what a gift, right? I mean, not least because I was a massive Harry Potter fan. So, I mean, I read that first book, and I was like, this is interesting. And I think the second book, The Chamber of Secrets, was the first book I read through the night. I genuinely, like sort of kids do in films, I had my head under the covers and a torch, and I couldn't stop reading. I mean, so to have been part of that sort of extraordinary journey and that extraordinarily ambitious attempt to sort of translate that world onto film is, you know, is wonderful. And the fact that it sort of keeps reaching new audiences is kind of amazing, right? And a testament to the source material. I mean, people keep falling in love with it. People sort of say, my kids are watching it. And I sort of thought, wow, you would have thought that there would be something else, maybe. Often these things are generational, films that people grow up with. But I think Harry Potter seems to have a bit of an enduring appeal. So, yeah, very, very, very grateful to have been part of it.